would to go ahead would destroy their environment, destroy their drinking water, cause massive pollution and risk the lives of up to 1 million people. You may have heard, but possibly not, of Anglo Gold Ashanti. It's a South African company which makes its money out of getting people to dig out gold from the bowels of the earth. In this case, they want to dig out gold from something like 12,000 feet up in the Andean Mountains. They want to chop the top off a mountain and dig an open cast mine 12,000 feet up. If you want to do something really stupid to contaminate the environment, then I suggest what you do is put a gold mine on top of the Andean Mountains. That's exactly what Anglo Gold Ashanti wants to do. And if it had its way, the people represented by this embassy, the Colombian government, would give them their way. Who needs more gold in this world? Well, probably some of the shoppers of Harrods would like even more gold. But basically, nobody in the world needs more gold. There is no excuse or reason for this mine except to make more money. Anglo Gold Ashanti are a bunch of crooks and robbers and hoodlums who should be kicked out of Colombia once and for all. They're digging up half the country in the search for gold. They're causing massive environmental damage already, and it's a great thing that the people of Cajamarca voted 98% to 2% against the gold mine going ahead. We say, Viva the people of Cajamarca!
Viva!
And they followed the example of another small town called Piedras, who in similar fashion voted 99% that the work of this gold mine should not go ahead in Piedras. We say, Viva the people of Piedras!
Viva!
And so today, in far off Colombia, there will be something like a quarter of a million people, mostly young people, many students, many school children, on the streets, marching for life and against the gold mines. They are marching for life and they are marching for their future. We say, Viva the young people of Ibagué!
Viva!
And all around Colombia today, there will be similar protests and festivals of life to defend the environment. There's a big problem. The problem is these multinational mining companies don't give a damn about the environment. If they see gold, or if they see coal, or if they see other minerals they can make massive profits out of, they're in there. And they try to push everybody out of the way in order to make their massive profits. And the problem is that the Colombian government has always allied with them. In fact, it makes this model its main object of the economy in Colombia. They want to see mining massive holes dug out all over the country. They even call it the main motor of the economy. But what it will do is destroy the environment and terrorize the people. Have you ever seen the film Independence Day? You know this little guy who says, we come in peace. They come in peace and then they zap everybody with their tasers and burn them into a cinder. Well, there's somebody, Mars Attack on Earth. It was Mars Attack, right? If you've seen the film Mars Attack, you know what I'm talking about. So Santos says he comes in peace. Santos comes in peace, and then he zaps the people in his way. Santos has come in peace to the people of Ibagué, and yet this year at least 12 or 14 activists to defend the environment have been assassinated. Santos has gone in peace to Buenaventura, the biggest port city of Colombia, and there he is zapped with his anti-mutiny riot police ESMAD. ESMAD have injured 300 people in Buenaventura. 300 people have been attacked. That's the peace of Santos. The peace of Santos is war against the people. The peace of Santos is killing babies. The peace of Santos is raiding homes at 4 o'clock in the morning. The peace of Santos means that the police go to the one clinic in Buenaventura and occupy it so that the injured people who go there are arrested. The peace of Santos is the doublespeak. The Nobel Prize winning Santos has declared war on his own people. He's declared war on his own people because they stand in the way of the mining companies. world publicity. This has not yet got into the British media. This trouble should be in the pages of the liberal and left-wing media, what's happening in Colombia. And it's not on in the media at all. We need to keep on mobilizing and finding ways. I want to propose, or at least best discuss this, that we have a picket here once a week, every Friday, whilst Buenaventura strike is going on. I don't know how people feel about that. I think there is a will to do this. But we can all go back into our communities. We should also be producing leaflets in Spanish and English. We should be mobilizing our communities and going to our communities to mobilize people for this picket. And I think that above all, what we have is a fantastic unity on this picket. We have fantastic goodwill. Everybody on this picket is here because we defend the environment and we defend the social movements in Colombia. But what we also need to do is to project that struggle and to really build a genuine and effective solidarity here. We have done it. It's a good start, but we need to have a higher ambition to push on and really mobilize the people who don't already know outside the Latin American community. We need to really tell people the truth about the death wars that are happening in Colombia. We need to tell them the truth about what ESMAD is doing right now to kill children in Buenaventura. That's really, only us can do that. Nobody else can do that. We have to really think of a way of trying to get their story out much further. We say, long live Environment Day, long live the people of Tolima, long live the people of Cajamarca, and long live the people of Buenaventura.